actually that made me think that there is sort of a platform here with video games where we have a voice, you know, and you can use that voice to say something. Subscribe to my channel. I feel like you know that this is special content here. Okay, so let's just get right into it. So this game, I think, is set in the 90s. I'm pretty sure right away we get sort of a sense of what year it is. I think it might have been like 96. And this is the company that made Tacoma, which is
Hi,
the
Mom.
Game that we just played.
So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
So it's set in Portland. I'm assuming Portland, Oregon. I don't really know of any other Portlands. Says I'm not here. sibling, and Sam doesn't want mom and dad to know, not just anyone. Okay, so this is a
has changed, even just since you've been away. We moved into this house. I'm at a new school. And my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier. It doesn't feel real. But I'm not gonna let it faze me. I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person, because you're off gallivanting around who knows where, I'll tell it to this journal, just like I was talking to you. Sounds like quite the adventure. Remember the little dorm room we shared freshman year? When we were miserable, fantasizing about our dream homes. I've always said I wanted a mansion. You said you just wanted a house in the woods. Look who got both. Somebody up there likes you. I could use some of that magic. Send me some lotto numbers, I'll play them. Seriously. But I shouldn't be complaining about this good old spirit level we've had since Bob got transferred to Winnipeg. Oh, that's Canadian. I didn't read that with proper punctuation, did I? There kind of isn't any. But I shouldn't be complaining about this old split level we've had since Bob got transferred to Winnipeg. We just got new vinyl siding. Jealous yet? Let me know if you ever want to trade places. So how are the girls doing? Has Katie left on her big European adventure yet? Speaking of jealous, get back soon. I miss you, Rumi Carol. I'm guessing that Jan is the mom and Carol is an old college roommate or whatever. What have you? I love lamp. Okay. The drawers after. I should just leave them all open. What's in here? Nothing. Nothing. Oh yeah, I went in there already. This is a really big foyer. That door is locked. Oh, okay. Shift is soon. This says 94, that says 95, that says 94. So I'm just trying to like build a timeline in my head. But right now it doesn't really add up.
Sam. Sam. Hello. Sam.
Talk to you. Please be there.
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
Says June 6, 95 over here. So I think I found a mistake actually in the game, which is funny, but whatever. We can always look past that. People make mistakes. Sam, Daniel from Old Neighborhood called. He wants to come see the new house. Call him back. Mom, Daniel is a total weirdo. The only reason I ever hung out with him in the first place is because he had a Nintendo when we were little. Yes. fellow high school as we are. Please be sure to bring the following with you on your first day of class. What is that sound? There's like a radio sound. Okay. So this looks like, oh, it's a severe weather warning. That's what it is. I can hear it. It says, this is a severe weather warning. So there's like a radio nearby. Everything is crossed off except a positive attitude. A nutritious lunch, a box of colored pencils, at least 6 pens, a sturdy folder, a lined notebook, but not a positive attitude. Do not bring your positive attitude to school. That's funny. Please remember to get plenty of sleep the night before and be ready for the first bell to ring at 8 a.m. See you soon. I'm guessing that was.
God. You are so lucky you finished high school before we moved into this house. So, it's the first day of school, and there I am, introducing myself to the class. And I say that I just moved into the house on Arbor Hill. All of a sudden, every kid in the room turns and just stares like I suddenly transformed into a mutant. I just stood there, wishing pretty hard for a rewind button. Because now maybe nobody knows my name. But they all know who I am. The Psycho House Girl. Great.
So this is a postcard that we sent home. It says, "Hi, Mom, Dad, and Sam. I'm in Paris. I've done many Parisian things, including eating Le Petit Douche of of film to develop when I get back. Sam, I'm bringing you back something from the Shakespeare Book Company, since you are my favorite sister. Love you all. 1 Arbor Hill, Weird, Boone Country, Oregon." Oscar Mason, 60, of the Boone Country, died peacefully last month in his home. Mr. Mason was born on September 8, 1933, in the house that would be his home for the rest of his life. He attained his degree in pharmacy at a young age and returned to Boone Country to practice. He quickly became a well-loved figure at the center of the community, and in the decades preceding his passing, he was seldom seen outside his home. A service will be held this Sunday at the First Methodist Church, 1 p.m. All are welcome. His survivors include his nephew Terrence Greenbrier. Okay, so that's the dad. As well as in spirit, the people of Boone Country, whom he provided wellness and comfort. So it looks like, this guy died here, and this is his house, and Terrence inherited it. So this is like a inherited house that somebody died in, and this looks like Sam. In the military. I want to say Sam. jack of all trades is a master of none. I have to disagree. Mastery is not a question of specialization, but sureness of purpose and dedication to craft. If you happen to be in the market for a combination LD-CD player, you'll be glad to know that Pioneer seems to share this particular... Looks like somebody was writing a thing for Pioneer. You can do better. What if JFK wasn't JFK? JFK president. Conspiracy theorist. Oh, I don't know the combination of this. Get me out of here. Is there any numbers written down over here? Russell opened his eyes and saw them, the stars, twinkling as if he were lying on the grass in his family's yard in Massachusetts. I always say that. Massachusetts. Even though that place was a million miles away. No. He blinked the sleep from his eyes, looking through the carbon-reinforced safety glasses of the space station Archimedes. Yes. He was a long way from home, but the future needed him. Okay, so it sounds like the dad is a writer. Excuse my shuffling around. So it sounds like the dad is a writer who gets paid to write dumb things about stereos, but actually wants to write his science fiction. Stories. I was a teenage drag queen. Fresh readers tell us about their worst moments. Does anybody still care? The male gaze, how to subvert it. Future save the president's life once, but within the next 24 hours there will be another attempt. The lines of communication are down. Oh, it's bad. And this is what's underneath it. The magazine for men, gentlemen. Japan's body war on, or bloody war on dolphins. Ladies in the ring. best-selling advice book for parents of teens. The teen years are fraught with change in all types of physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual, of all types. But these changes don't just affect your teen. Your teen's turbulent years are a challenge for parents as well. Maybe the biggest challenge you've yet faced since having children. This book holds insights into your teen's behavior from the very beginning, as he or she first enters adolescence, up through the end of the teen years, as he or she enters young adulthood. The practical strategies here are based upon well-tested principles of pediatric psychology presented by Dr. Elsa Mendina herself, a mother of two teenagers. This isn't the mom, is it? No. Prepare to gain new tools for establishing a productive, healthy, loving dialogue with the stranger under your roof. I never had such a good conversation with my daughter, says Eleanor Shepherd. These simple tools can make all the difference to a relationship with your child, says Sean something. So the mom's name is Jan, so this isn't like a book the mom wrote or anything. But sounds like they needed some help with being a parent. Dear Terrence, David asked me to write you regarding the reviews you've been submitting the last 4 months. Frankly, they're becoming more trouble than they're worth from an editing standpoint. There's a word limit. It's your job to stay under it, not mine to cut back to it. Even then, it's becoming harder and harder to weed the tangents and non-squinchers from this table copy without heavy rewrites. The readers of home theater aficionado want to hear about the quality and value of the hardware, not the ruminations on your childhood. If it were up to me, I wouldn't be writing this letter. I'd just be cutting you loose. There's tons of guys half your age who would take half your rate to write stuff I could actually use. But David's known you for a long time, and he's the boss, so I'm giving you one more shot on his say-so. You should write him a nice note thanking him for his patience and generosity. Look through your old stuff and start submitting reviews like that again. Then everybody will be happy. Brent Kirkwood, reviews editor for Home Theater Aficionado magazine. I think this might be the passcode for the filing cabinet. This one has a title on the spine, and none of the other ones do. I feel like it must be significant in some way. Filling in, bending. I don't know. I feel like it. original document and typed a copy for your records. The notarized copy has been filed at our offices. Thank you for entrusting our firm with this important matter. I, Oscar Mason. Oh, this is the guy who owned the house and died. Possessing full competence of mind and memory after full survey of valued items to my name, do hereby declare this document my last will and testament. The following shall hold true upon my passing. 1. I declare that I'm a lifelong resident of Boone Country and that I'm unmarried and have no children. 2. I declare that I have no outstanding debts to my name, any creditors living or dead. 3. I do hereby bequeath every item of value of which I may die possessed, including the dwelling and surrounding acres located at Arbor Hill, as well as any and all personal property and moneyed accounts to my nephew, Terrence Greenbrer. I don't know how to say that. Greenbrer. Junior of Ellis County. In the event that said Terrence L. Greenbrer Junior should predecease me, then in such event, the bequest to him shall fall, and the same is bequeathed to his children in ordered by age and competence as stewards of the estate. I subscribe my name to this will, this 13th day of August 1973, signed Oscar Mason. So that this will is the same year that I was born. Same thing in handwriting, which I'm not going to attempt to read because that looked pretty messy. So,
stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevation.
This is what I've been hearing. Severe weather warning. There's a, I guess, a VHS player missing.
This is a severe weather warning.
Or maybe it's a Nintendo, who knows. Lots of VHSs, though. Press C or Control to crouch.
John County, Tecumseh County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay in
the area.
Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
So this looks like a fort that maybe Sam built. Dr. Jitters. Okay.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties: Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Tecumseh County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
The Accidental Survivor. Books about JFK. Terry, hey man, how have you been? I know you're a published author and everything now, but my editor at HF Aficionado has had too much review work to go around, and he's looking for another freelancer. Naturally, I thought of you. You were saying in your last letter how much of a pain it's been trying to find a publisher. exposure for your latest work of literature and writing. Stereo reviews is dead simple. Sit at home with a glass of scotch, listen to some records, and write how it sounds, and then get paid. I've included some issues of the mag to use as examples if you're interested. Send some samples to my editor. Tell him you're an old colleague from... Tell him your old colleague chum Mike sent you. Here's the address. Okay. So it looks like he kind of got stuck doing a job he hated. The heaven at the edge of the world, Samantha Greenbrier. Story, The Turtle People, Part 1. It's my kind of book. Captain Elgra looked off at the ocean. It went on forever, or so it seemed. Someday she would find the edge and get to the paradise there. Then she heard a cannon fire. Boom. It was the black pirate ship, she yelled. I thought we lost them at Horse Island, the first mate says. Looks like you thought too soon. The black ship came up along the side. Captain Black himself came out on the deck of the black ship. He yelled to Captain Allegra. Yar, never gonna find the edge. Thar ain't no paradise, and yar father. Imbecile. The first mate yelled out, we'll stop you, Captain Black. We'll find the edge of the world and you'll see her father was no liar. The battle kept going until Captain Allegra's ship got away. Now west, she said, and the ship sailed towards the sunset. Looks like there's a prodigy writer in the family.
And the Starry account. Residents are strongly urged.
Making friends, Sam. Thought this might help Dad. Oh, that's embarrassing.
You know that feeling where the first moment you see someone, it's like they have a big gold star around them, and you have to get to know them. Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk, but sometimes I see her in this, like, army uniform, and she's always drawing in this notebook, looking so intense. I had no idea how I would ever, like, have an excuse to talk to her. Till I noticed she and her friends hang out and play Street Fighter at the 7-Eleven every day after school.
Right back. Hi, Tommy. Yes, I'm Samantha. And yes, I'm new. What's up? Just thought, since you're new, maybe you could use a friend. I don't have a lot of friends either, so I thought I'd ask something, if you don't mind. Do you mind? Yes or no? No, I don't mind. What do you want to ask? What's it just your uncle who went psycho, or does it run in the family? Ah. Tommy. That is not very nice. Okay, so I've been all down here. What? This is the way to go. Samantha, please give this to your mother. Janice, thank you for having Danny over to your new home. He has missed having his friend Samantha in the neighborhood very much. Danny asked if he could lend Samantha his Nintendo Street Fighting tape, and I gave my permission. He needs to spend less time with those games anyways. No hurry returning it. Let Samantha know that she is welcome back to our house to visit anytime. Sincerely, Mary Schwartz. God, I'm so bad with stuff like that.
When you live in one place your whole life, your next door neighbor is kind of like your default friend. And Daniel only got weirder over the years. So moving away has been a good excuse to, like, not see him anymore. But he did always have the good Nintendo games. Maybe I'll give him a call.
I know exactly what she's talking about. I had a neighbor who was my default friend. Dear Miss Greenbrer, I write to inform you that unfortunately Mercury Books will be unable to publish your follow-up to The Accidental Pharaoh, despite a low sales of The Accidental Savior. We went ahead with publication of the second book in hopes that John Russell's series catching on. However, sales of the second book have in fact been lower than those of the first, and so our stewardship of the series must end here. It has been a pleasure working as your publisher, and we wish you and John Russell the best in the future. Oh, okay, so this was like a team effort. Oh, and this is... And this is 1976, so... this was a long time ago. This was when our character would have been 3. And I have to turn that off. Okay, I gotta read this. Samantha. Okay, so this is a reproductive system worksheet. Okay, below are two stories. The events are all out of order. Get a sheet of lined paper, write reproductive system worksheet number 6 at the top, and then choose one of the two stories, A or B. And write it. Begin with the title to begin your paragraph, but the sentence is in chronological order. Make sure the last sentence is a good concluding statement. A. The menstrual cycle, it travels through the fallopian tube. The ovary releases the ovum about 2 weeks later. Since the lining of the uterus is not needed for pregnancy, it comes out through the vagina. It is incredible how the female body knows how to prepare for pregnancy. If the egg doesn't meet the sperm, it dissolves. While the ovum is developing, the lining of the uterus is getting thick and so I don't want to read this right now. Let's just read what she wrote. Okay. Period 4, health class, reproductive system worksheet, the menstrual cycle, a novella. The early morning of September 1st, 1939, Essa Glatz stares out the window of the train as it travels from Vienna back to her home village in Willen in Portland. Of Willen in Portland. What was it that? As the train rambles along and the sun rises over the countryside, she can only think of her Boris Lay, the boy she's engaged to wed. Meanwhile, deep within her guts, an ovum starts to develop. As this train approaches its destination, her heart races. The lining of her uterus is getting thick and soft. Oh my god. As Essa steps off the train, her eyes dart quickly across the gathered crowd. Then there, her dear Boris, still in his baker's smock. He must have dropped his early morning duties at his father's shop to come meet her. Her heart skips a beat. The ovary releases the ovum. It travels through the fallopian tube. Over the wheezing of the steam engines, a deep hum grows. It's coming from the sky. Dark shadows pass over the station. A whistling sound. Essa, her thoughts only a second faster than the bombs reaching out toward her dear Boris across the crowd. Their eyes lock, and the moment freezes. The flash and smoke envelops him almost instantly. In the assault of the German forces, almost 75% of the people in her hometown are killed. The rest, including Essa. And for a time, Borislav, huddled in a half-destroyed church. He is blind, his legs are missing, damaged with torn bed sheets. As his egg will not be meeting his sperm, it dissolves. Oh my god. About 2 weeks later, Boris loses his grip on life. Essa has given up her rations to keep Boris alive. But in the end, nothing can save him. Since the lining of the uterus is not needed for a pregnancy, it comes out through the vagina. Essa vows to survive. She sets off to join the Polish resistance as a daring spy and saboteur. Another ovum starts to develop in one of the ovaries, and the process begins again. It's incredible how the female body knows how to prepare for pregnancy. And it says in red, "See me." So Sam is freaking hilarious. And also kind of rebellious against school, but very smart. Still this afternoon, that would be cool. I can drive so hopefully that's fine. Write back and leave this in my locker if you still want, and we can meet in the parking lot after 6th, Samantha. Yeah, I'm totally in. See you there. Then I'm gonna kick your butt. Get ready. I guess they're gonna play Street Fighter on the Nintendo.
So you know what they say about the best laid plans of mice and men? Yeah, turns out it applies to Street Fighter too. At least I worked up the courage to walk into the 7-Eleven and ask for a turn, but all that practice at home did not exactly translate in the wild. So after I was finished getting my butt kicked, I followed them outside while they smoked. And that was when she asked me if I was that psycho house girl. But then she said she's always really wanted to see the psycho house. Her name is Lonnie. She's coming over tomorrow.
Katie, please tell Mom and Dad sorry about the stuff that's missing. Wednesday cooking class, Friday ballroom dancing, for Sam.
It's weird hanging out with girls. Daniel was around ever since I was little, and other girls? I don't know. But being around Lonnie is like instantly just right. I gave her the grand Psycho House tour and took my revenge on Super Nintendo. And it was like, I don't know. I finally found someone I feel normal around. I drove her home and she gave me this tape and said, "You have got to listen to this." I haven't stopped playing it since.
Steggy. This is the one me and my dad are building. Want to go for a ride when it's done? Assignment, metal plaque for family portrait, reasonable subject but not complex. When I said that Mom and Dad should be replaced with parents' names, I did not mean just write them underneath. Acceptable leveling on edges, show more pride in your work, in metalworking, engraving. So. first mate slid down the line onto the stone floor. She swept chalky bone dust from the front of her canvas trousers and looked up at Allegra. The silken thread, nay, unbreakable, thanks to enchanted moss that inhabited the island, trailed behind them, leading their way back to the entrance from further into the labyrinth. A moaning began to echo. The moaning grew louder and clearer. It turned into words from some ancient language they could not understand. The king's cursed voice and the hairs on Captain Allegra aren't. Mate, whose eyes remained locked on the blackness of the passage for a moment too long before noticing the captain's gaze. The first mate nodded silently ahead, following the king's closely slung deeper and deeper into the labyrinth. They came upon a rocky gap spilling forth outer-worldly blue light. The great basin of the dead king's throne lay below. Skeletal and rotted robes, the king was hunched over the blue orb, topping his royal specter. Shadows of his bony fingers danced on the walls like ghouls as he sang. Wailing souls flowed in one by one through the cracks in the caves in the walls. Funny stuff is funny, but that's not good. Got your number. Can I get your number? I used to have a game just like this. I know what game this is making fun of. It's called Dream Phone. It might be a mixture of Dream Phone and Girl Talk, actually. Those were both games in the 90s. And this is very obviously a Lisa Frank. Perfect for you.
Emily brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate. I don't know if I've touched someone else's scalp before. It's pretty intimate, right? It felt intimate. We looked in the mirror together after, and I expected her to say something about how it looked crappy or good or whatever. But that's when she said, you're so beautiful. And she was looking at me. Right in that moment, I wanted to say something, but I waited, and the moment was gone.
So, if you couldn't tell, this is a story of Sam falling in love with a girl. Sam also being supposed to be really violent. Am I going to barf? According to Todd, it is pretty hardcore. I guess Uma Thurman gets stabbed in the heart with a heroin needle. So that's kind of hilarious. Something about cheeseburgers is important. Todd wants to see it again. 7:15, okay? Don't barf. Perfect. pictures. I want the whole package. Wait, that sounded wrong. Keep your chin up until Terry is out of his slump. And in the meantime, write more letters to your old friend Carol. She adores them. Ranger Rick. Huh, Jen? Ranger Rick. I see what's going on. Watercolor techniques. Somebody fancies themselves an artist, I suppose. What's under the bed here? Take your time. I'm glad to have it in good hands, Rick. Okay. What is it, though? Walt Whitman. Leasograss. A collection of poems was released in this form, but not before it was banned on grounds of obscenity. He died only 2 months after its release. Seeing, hearing, feeling are miracles, and each part and tag of me is a miracle. So he's sharing dirty poems with her. That we know for sure. Discovering your spouse personally, spiritually, sexually. So they have marriage problems and other people are involved, I guess. Aw, Mitten. Mitten our cat. Done by Caitlin at age 5. Cassidy, All the President's Men. All righty then. I did all this already. Hey Sam, you were asking what my Jerock ribbons meant. Here is a handy guide. Orienteering. This means the army thinks I can fly my way around. Rifle team, the army has branded me as a certified killing machine. Adventure training. I'm a bird, adventurous, and no border can hold me. The army recognizes this. So if you didn't think I was cool before, now you do, Lonnie D. Another thing I just thought of. This is 1994, being in the army and being out as gay or lesbian, I think was a big no-no for the army. 31st, 1994. A tall shadow in the upstairs hall. When I rounded the corner, no one was there. How tall was Uncle Oscar? Notice I was not wearing my glasses. September 3rd, 1994, 12:44 a.m. A faint voice coming from the bottom of the stairs. I said hello. Did not investigate. Probably was the furnace. September 9th, 1994, 4 p.m. Poured milk from a carton in the fridge. It was spoiled. Pretty sure I read that spirits can sour milk. Milk was bought yesterday. Ghost milk. October 9th, 1994. Lonnie says she feels a presence in the TV room. I suddenly began to feel cold. We built a protective pillow fort. October 22nd. Disturbing messages are conveyed from the other side. Oscar is definitely here. October 28th, 1994. Enlisted Lonnie to stay up all night and help patrol premises, recording any signs of otherworldly presence. Lonnie reported many sightings, but all remained unconfirmed. Possible ectoplasm in the attic, probably due to leaky roof. Sample taken just in case. Despite our best efforts, we both fell asleep around 4 a.m. All in all, a successful night. Somebody's ghost hunting. Oh, and look, it's all my clothes and things and Katie stuff, and that's me and you. Katie, Mom and Dad are going to make up the guest room for you to stay in over the summer, but you came home on such short notice that they weren't around to do it. You can use my room if you want. I won't be needing it anymore, Sam. So Sam has hastily left. Bum, 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 bum. And doesn't want Mom and Dad to know where she is. Story is coming together, but I don't want to say it out loud yet. Performance evaluation, Richard Petermuck. Ranger Petermuck has been indispensable during the course at the prescribed burn preparation and execution. I believe his expertise and dedication has been the deciding factor in the success of a very complex and challenging conservation effort. In the opinion of the Flintlock Forest staff, Rick's contributions to daily operations have become essential to the outfit's continuing success. To this end, I will be formally submitting paperwork requesting his permanent reassignment to this facility. Signed, Janice Greenbrabra. So she's like Ranger Rick's boss, and she is evaluating him, and he is sharing dirty poetry with her. How provocative. I guess this is her painting room, and she's painting a still life. From the raging flames, and things really heated up. So she's also reading some, what are those books called? I can't remember right now, it's late. But she's reading some naughty books that mimic her life with Ranger Rick. Something in the corner, and I found a see this. We're skipping sixth. Where is this? Closet. I was in the library. Okay.
Sometimes you just have to lie to mom and dad. Like when Lonnie asked me to see a band with her and stay over at her friend's place in the city after. That's a lie to mom and dad situation. But it was so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome. And everybody was moving together like one huge tide of sound. Between two songs, Lonnie leaned over and said, "How do you like your first show?" I was so happy. I felt tears starting in my eyes. And then she up and hugged me. I think she could tell.
I want a secret passage.
Todd's brother's place after the show, there was only a futon to sleep on, so Lonnie and I shared it. The lights went out. I was turned toward her. My eyes started to adjust, and then I could see she was looking at me, too. In the dark, she smiled. My heart was beating so fast. I rolled over. I felt so, I don't know, nervous? After a minute, she put her arm around me, and was so close, and whispered in my ear, "I really like you." I just nodded my head, and I really hope she could tell. I really hope that she meant what I think she did. I felt like a shook-up can of soda ever since. I hope we have the chance to talk before I explode.
Sam's locker combo. Oh, only half. Also, here's an idea for something to draw. Two cats on a motorcycle. Hey, this is a good idea. What are all the cool kids actually doing? Sending each other pages on their beepers, but we're cooler than them because guess what? They can't put this on a beeper. Your drawing of a cat was so good that I added a background to it. Even better, maybe I should just of cats. Also, like, his secret shame is he watches 90210 religiously. I'll ask him about it after class. He said he doesn't have cats. Also, that he never watched 90210, but I could see his eyes were lying.
This
Johnny came over today. But everything was different. She was sitting at my desk chair, and she wouldn't look at me. Finally, I asked her what was going on. She said she felt like she'd done something wrong that night in the city. Like I must think... But I said no. There was nothing wrong. I just wanted to say... But I couldn't find the words. I felt like I was gonna cry, but I wasn't sad. She got up and sat next to me on the bed. I looked at her. Lonnie, do you think you could ever... And that's when she kissed me. It's different now. I mean, we still hang out all the time like before. But now when no one else is around... Well, you know. So you could say we're dating. But it's secret. Secret dating? I don't know. I mean, I guess that's the real difference. Now when we get off the phone or go home for the night, where it's just quiet and we're alone, we say I love you.
Congratulations, I am pleased to inform you of your admission to the Creative Writing Track of Reed College Summer Program for Young Scholars for its 1995 session. We believe you have much to contribute to the Reed College community. Based on your portfolio and academic record, I am pleased to offer you financial aid to cover 75% of the summer program's tuition and fees. The attached documentation delineates your schedule, optional secondary track choices, and your dormitory assignment. Please remember to submit the attached form if you wish to be eligible for the 3 Reed full-time undergraduate scholarships to be awarded to exemplary students at the end of each summer program. Look forward to your attendance. Again, congratulations on your admission and best wishes from all of us at Reed College.
I'm so stupid sometimes. I was telling Lonnie that I got into my college summer program thing, and I was all making plans like, you should come visit me, stay in my dorm room. But she said, Sam, I ship out on June 6th. I was like, ship out? To where? She said, to basic training. What did you think I was doing all that ROTC stuff for? I guess she's been planning to join the army right after high school since she was, like, 12. And I guess she's really going to do it. So I was like, after graduation, I'm just never going to see you again? She said, let's just have fun while we can.
For sending along a copy of your newly published book, the author's first published manuscript. In a moment's occasion, I read it this afternoon. I certainly recognized my son in the subject matter. The author's work is an externalization of that which he holds dear and that which he fears. And in this respect, I believe your work was successful. these hungrily, but I urge you to shed artifice. You can do better with a father's love and encouragement. Oh, that fucking stinks. My opinion, too.
Lost their singer. Todd said he sucked. Lonnie said he got sick of Todd's shit, and he was complaining about needing a new singer, so Lonnie was like, I can sing. And they were all kind of like, you can? And she was like, probably. But she's been rehearsing with them for like a week now, and I finally got to see them play in Todd's basement today. And she's actually really amazing. I feel so when she's on stage. It's incredible being in awe of someone you love. So everybody knows it's like a temporary situation till she ships out in June. But till then, I'm gonna be at every single show.
Thank you. March, and I don't know if anyone running this school has been to Oregon, but it's cold and rainy as shit in March. Wish you were here. Oh wait, you are here, because I'm writing this to you in the gift shop. Oh shit, here you come.
They tell you to stick with the group on field trips, Katie. There's a reason for that. Lonnie and I snuck off on the side paths at Multnomah Falls and got a little lost. Okay, a lot lost. Like, for hours. Right before the bus left, we found a trail and came running down the path, soaked and covered in mud, shouting for the bus not to leave. The school called home. Mom and Dad said, "You didn't get into trouble like this before you met that Lonnie girl." But I don't think they know about us. Kids at school, though, I'm really afraid that's a whole other story. Stick with the group, Katie. Stick with the group. Lonnie sometimes. Like, her band and our zine and her hair and everything are all anti-authority. But I watch her in JROTC and she's doing drills in perfect formation, following orders, no question. And there's all this stuff in the news about don't ask, don't tell. Like, she's going to join the army and then have to lie about who she is. She said they don't need to know what they don't need to know. Like it was no big deal. This from the girl who trashed her locker to, like, defend my honor. I've learned when to stop arguing, though. I don't think Lonnie even gets Lonnie sometimes.
Shortcut. responsible for operations throughout the northwestern Oregon. Your assistance would be sought to fill your previous position on site at the Flintlock National Forest. Your new posting would be at the regional management building located at 128 Bullhorn Road, which should be much more convenient for your daily commute. Please respond as soon as possible. Research and education. Hi, Jen. I got 2 tickets for the Earth, Wind, and Fire on Thursday, but my girlfriend says she doesn't want to go. Her taste in music rears its ugly head again. So that leaves me with an extra ticket that I thought you might be interested in. Since you refused to hear us out this afternoon, your mother and I are putting this in writing so that we are absolutely clear. You are grounded for the rest of the month from social and telephone privileges and from using your car for anything except going to and from school. We understand that you are what you are going through, but we can't allow you to continue with this kind of behavior at school. And clearly, once your privileges are reinstated, we can't allow you to have your bedroom door closed while Lonnie is at the house. This is the last word on the matter. Get back on course so this won't have to happen again, Dad. Disciplinary referral, Samantha, distributing inappropriate materials.
I had an interesting talk with Mom and Dad tonight. One you are never gonna need to have. I mean, you've known, right? I've known since, like, She-Ra. Mom and Dad didn't, I guess. But they saw the zine and the stuff on the locker, and they were like, is there something we should know about you and Lonnie? And so here's the thing. I was prepared for them to be mad, or disappointed, or start crying, or something, but they were just in denial. You're too young to know what you want. You and Lonnie are just good friends. You just haven't met the right boy. It's a phase. That's what I didn't see coming. That they wouldn't even respect me enough to believe me. Well, joke's on them. Because they're in for one very long phase.
You sound like you're reading a lot into an incident, innocent night out. You're sure there's something there? You said he has an out-of-town girlfriend. You're sure they're not serious? Okay, so we have to figure out when we'll see each other next, in person. Enough with the letters. I owe you a congratulatory margarita, boss lady. Soon, love, Carol. This is the biggest table I have ever seen. Oh yeah, there's a postcard over here. From us. Us as in our character. Hi, Mom and Dad and Sam. The vacation is weird. As you can see, the Catholic Church still has a lot of money left over from the Middle Ages. I've gotten to see all the art. Sistine Chapel ceiling and the sculptures by Michelangelo, Donatello, and the rest of the Ninja Turtles. Mom, we have to come back together. I would love to be here with someone who really appreciates the history behind everything. Also, Sam, they have various relics as pieces of important dead people, so you should probably come too. Next stop, Barcelona. Calm down, Dad. I feel to order pizza while we're gone. Be good, Dad. Start from the beginning. Unknown Dimension is what you might call a specialist publishing house. We traffic in the weird, the ahead of its time, the lost but not forgotten by a small but dedicated group of plugged in bibliophiles. Works such as Message of the Snake Man, It's Inside Me. Oh no. His book, they want to publish his dumb book. We want permission to reprint the work since your original publisher, Mercury Books, folded a decade ago. We want you to supply a to appear in brand new editions of The Accidental Survivor and The Accidental Pharaoh, to be produced by Unknown Dimension as a limited run marketed directory for our highly discerning customer base, and we want to offer you a portion of the proceeds. Contract to follow, assuming you're interested in coming along with us for this weird odyssey. We look forward trusting your work, screaming back into the sweating palms of an unsuspecting American public. It's about time. Okay. Short notice, can't wait to see you again. It'll be good to be home. Love, Katie. Booted out. Girl Scout. Last show ever.
Mommy had her going away show with her band tonight. She's so incredible on stage. And she was singing, I could practically forget everything. We only had 48 hours left. That I don't know what comes next. That I can't live without her. Then she dedicated the last song to me. I couldn't take it. I was out on the curb in the alley, sobbing till my ribs hurt. I would follow her anywhere, Katie. But but I can't. Where she's going. After a long time, she found me. She said she was sorry. She said, I wish things could be different. I just wanted to make you happy. I said, I don't think you can anymore.
Another secret room.
We agreed our last night together would be our happiest ever. And we'd forget tomorrow was going to come at all. It worked for a while. We had a good time seeing Oscar off. Then ran up to the attic to look through our photos. To find one for Lonnie to take with her. And looking at them, I realized they were all in the past. And there wouldn't be any more. I didn't know what I was going to do. And I cried. And she held me. She said she knew it was hard, but life would move on. I said I didn't want my life to keep moving without her. That's when she cried too. I was so exhausted. I must have fallen asleep like that, in her arms. In the morning, I woke up, and I was finally alone.
Twice he saved a president's life. He's practically forgotten the days of the future, the danger, the excitement, the days where he matured. So when that familiar rip in time opens in front of him, his handlers peer out. He doesn't hesitate. Is the president in danger? God, Dad is such a bad writer. I can't tell you what a joy it is to see John Russell back in print. Thank you so much for sending along copies of the new editions. The cover art is really something. I know you said Unknown Dimensions isn't in the business of printing new material, but it's revived interest in my work and has brought on a wave of inspiration, resulting in a manuscript that completes John Russell's journey, which I think you may find intriguing. It is reflective and introspective, without forgetting the excitement and weirdness that Unknown Dimension readers expect. This might be an exciting new direction for Unknown Dimension to pursue. At the very least, I am grateful that John Russell's adventures didn't come to an end quite when I thought they had. Oh, he got a new inspiration and motivation to write.
The sunset light in this house is the saddest thing I've ever seen. I just want to sleep. When I'm in the attic, it almost feels like Lonnie could still be here. She's just downstairs. I'm just waiting to hear her pull down the hatch and come running up. Maybe I'll go up to the attic and wait.
Secret passageways.
sleep in the attic, in Lonnie and my old spot, and I missed the first two calls. I just barely caught the third one before the machine got it. And it was Lonnie, on a payphone. She'd been on the bus to Basic, and she said she couldn't think of anything but me and us, and that she couldn't go through with it, with the army and being a part and all of it. And so she got off the bus in Salem. She said, Sam, I want you to pack up everything you can and get in your car and come find me. And let's just drive until we find somewhere for us. And she asked me if I could do that. And I said, yes. Yes. Katie, I'm so sorry that I can't be there to see you in person, that I can't tell you all this myself, but I hope as you read this journal and you think back, that you'll understand why I had to do what I did, and that you won't be sad, and you won't hate me, and you'll just know that I am where I need to be. I love you so much, Katie. I'll see you again someday.